The Hansons are spreading their wings.
See, Anna? This is Mommy's new business. It's gonna pay for your college education and Mommy's new thighs.
Sometimes learning something new.
The rings, right under his ear, show how he's feeling. They change color if he's sad or happy or even in love.
You kidding?
No.
And sometimes making the same mistakes.
How about dinner?
Dinner would be great.
Mob or no mob, the guy knows how to start a girl's day.
I hope you like it.
It's perfect.
Do you know one person who can say for sure that the Retigliato family has done anything wrong?
No.
Because they're all at the bottom of the Providence River.
It's time, Sid. Mm. Come on, darling. Everyone's waiting. Come on, hurry.
What?
You don't want to be late for your last supper, do you?
What's that smell?
Bad judgment, raging hormones, destiny.
Who are these women?
Your role models, apparently. Time to operate, doctor. Scalpel. Stir.
How long?
I don't know. Excuse me, how long have you been stirring?
47 years.
If you end up with Paul, this is pretty much it for you.
You're the one who told me to take the chance with Paul.
I had no idea it'd go this far. You better stir.
I don't want to stir.
You think you're too good to stir?
No.
Then stir.
Stir! 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 Stir!
Lily got up early and decided to cook us breakfast.
The spinach tofu scramble gets an A+.
Wow, Lily, you really did your homework, huh?
Since you're running late, Sid, I'm making yours to go. English muffin, lightly toasted with a touch of honey.
Thank you. Sounds great.
Hey, is the kitchen still open?
You bet. One ham and cheese cheddar omelet coming right up.
Thanks.
My pleasure.
So, Joanie, how's business at your bakery doing?
Yeah, I don't know what's happened. The grand opening was so grand, but now, besides a few regulars, the place is pretty empty.
Heather keeps passing out your flyers.
Why don't you just give out more free samples?
You're thinking too small. What you should do is a TV commercial.
Oh, yeah, with my $1 million ad budget.
Have you ever heard of cable access?
Oh, sorry, Robbie. I'm not trying to reach the stoner Trekkie demographic.
It's really not that bad an idea. I thought about doing a commercial for the clinic on it.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, actually, I know a couple of film students, so if you want, just say the word.
Breakfast. Oh, I forgot. Same for you. It's from Paul.
Oh. Well, don't hold out on us. Tell us what it says.
It's personal.
Dad, it's keeping secrets from me.
Don't tease your sister.
Goodbye, everyone. Have a nice day. Thanks for the breakfast.
Sid!
Hi, Jackie. I'm Dr. Hansen. How old are you?
14.
Well, I need permission to examine you. Is there somebody here with you?
No, but I've been here by myself before. My mom usually sends a note, but she's out of town right now.
Are you staying home by yourself?
No, my aunt's looking after me, but she's at work.
Oh, good. Here we go. We have a permission slip on file for you. So the nurse says that you're feeling really tired lately.
Yes, ma'am. And I also get stomach aches. And sometimes, out of the blue, I get real hot and start sweating.
Your lymph nodes seem fine. I'm hearing a little cracking in your voice. Has it started to change recently?
Yes, ma'am.
Your body may just simply be adjusting to puberty, but I'd still like to run some tests. So we're gonna start with a urine sample. The bathroom is down the hall to the left, and then you can meet me back here. Take your time. It's open.
Good book.
If you like childhood diseases associated with puberty. Thank you for thinking of me this morning.
I've thought of little else since we danced.
What's up?
Your roof, but not for long.
It's an old building.
Yeah, well, I just finished putting up a new building. We have some roofing left over. Consider it a donation.
Paul, I don't think...
Materials are paid for. My crew needs something to do. And besides, in kindergarten, Sister Bernadette used to say it was a sin to let anything go to waste. They can start tomorrow.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. Will you have dinner with me tonight? I was going to ask you out for Saturday, but now that I'm with you, just seems too far away.
Oh, I'm sorry. I just needed to get a file.
It's okay, Helen. This is Paul Vertigliata.
Hi.
Oh, the cappuccino guy.
Yes. Paul's donating a new roof for the clinic.
Well, that's a very generous offer. Excuse me.
I shall let you get back to work. Can I call you later about dinner tonight?
I'd like that.
Goodbye.
What? What?
Sid, you just accepted a $30,000 roof on behalf of this clinic from a man with ties to organized crime.
No, wait a minute. Paul is not involved in that.
I have to get back to my patient. We'll continue this later, but please be careful, Sid. For all of our sakes.
Hey, Dad, you down here? Hey, I think you should pick on someone your own size.
Rufus!
Thanks. Where's Dad?
House call. Can I be of service?
I actually need dogs for Joanie's commercial.
What kind?
I don't know. Cheap ones, weak ones.
Okay. I could probably get a couple of our clients to do it for a free grooming.
Well, it's a terrific idea, except for the fact that I have no idea how to groom animals.
I do.
You do that?
Yeah. Just let me know what kind you need, and I'll set it up.
Heather, you are amazing! I gotta go tell Joey.
Hey, Alan. You seen a 14-year-old boy running around here? I asked him for a urine specimen an hour ago.
Maybe he fell in.
Nick Beacons?
Ex-boyfriend?
No, I went to college with this guy, major conspiracy theorist. Whenever I was afraid he was gonna ask me out, I would just tell him that I thought Oswald acted alone.
If I were you, I'd get ready with a snappy retort about the grassy knoll.
Nick. Hey. How are you?
I'm fine, Sydney. And you are as beautiful as ever.
Are you here as a patient?
No, I just found out you got back in town, and I wondered if I could have a word with you in private.
Come on in.
Welcome back to Providence.
Thanks. I haven't had much time to catch up with old friends yet. Have a seat.
Actually, I'm here about one of your new friends.
Who's that?
Paul Vertigliata.
What about him?
I think you'd be wise to steer clear.
I don't see how that's any of your business.
Sydney, I work in the district attorney's office. Paul Vertigliato is under criminal investigation. These are from a surveillance report.
What is this?
It's a friendly warning, Sid. Any further involvement with him will make you part of the investigation. That could lead to criminal charges.
Nonchalant. I mean, we had a moment.
Robbie, why don't you try a real man? Where's your daddy?
Well, it's certainly not you, Larry.
Fred, Jed, where's your daddy? Where's your daddy?
How's the fort?
Held down, Dr. Hansen. Ouch. Oh, no, it's okay. Okay. So, I did what you suggested, and I sang to Rufus while I put his collar on, and it worked like a charm.
Rufus.
That's great, Heather. I knew if anybody could get him to do it, you'd be the one.
Dr. Hansen?
Mm-hmm.
Are you as good at figuring out humans as you are animals?
Some would say no. You have a human problem?
Well, there's this guy, and he obviously likes me. I mean, we had a moment.
A moment?
A couple, actually. But he hasn't asked me out.
Well, I had a few moments when I was your age. I was always too shy to follow them up. Girls pretty much had to hit me over the head to let me know it was safe to proceed.
So you think I should hit him?
I think you might want to consider being the one to do the asking.
The asking?
So the idea is a man on the street.
Only it's not a man, it's a dog.
On the street?
Yeah.
I don't get it.
Well, there's a dog.
On the street, I got that.
Good. So, the word out on the street is the Barkery is the place to go, right?
So he combs the city, you know, looking for the place, and then he gets here, and you guys have some kind of witty banter.
Dogs can't talk.
Okay, it's not a real dog. It's a guy.
Now, wait a minute. I thought you said it was a dog.
No, it's a guy dressed up in a dog suit.
Oh, great. Then I'm gonna have a bunch of weirdos coming in dressed up as animals.
Nobody's gonna take it literally. You think G.I. Joe can really drive a tank and Barbie can sing in a rock and roll band? It's advertising. Hannah.
See? Hannah thought it was a stupid idea, too.
Hi, guys.
Hey, Lily. I thought today was your afternoon at the clinic.
Slow day. They sent me home, so I came by to see if you guys needed any help.
Actually, we do. Do you think that you could, watch Hannah until we shoot this commercial?
Mommy!
Come on, we don't have much time, and I need you to focus.
And abdicate my responsibilities as a mother?
Don't be so dramatic. You'll see her at night. Meanwhile, we'll save your business.
I love hanging out with her, Joanie.
Okay, if you don't mind.
Yes!
See you later.
All right, so, to recap.
Dog on the street. I got it.
Thank God.
Dr. Hansen?
Yeah.
I got that sample you wanted.
Hey, I thought we'd seen the last of you.
I didn't have to go before. It took me a while.
Well, it happens sometimes. Come with me, okay? It's all right, just this way. Having any problems at school, Jackie?
What kind?
Any kind. Sometimes stress can magnify the effects of puberty.
Sometimes I get real mad. I'll yell and scream, and then I'll just start crying.
I need to do a blood test for you here. Can you take off your jacket? It's all right. It's a microneedle. You won't feel a thing.
I don't know.
Well, it's the only way we're going to figure out what's wrong with you. And as soon as I do, I will give you a call, okay?
Well, our phone's not working. Why don't I just come back?
All right. Why don't you make it Wednesday afternoon?
Wednesday.
Don't worry. I'm really good at this.
Bettino, the Boston Terrier, fine. Chuck, the Basset Hound, good.
The Beagles, who are they?
The strays Mr. Finnegan took in. George and Ringo are really sweet and really playful. John's got a mind of his own.
And let me guess, Paul's the cute one. You've done an amazing job, Heather.
You know, when this is over, we should celebrate.
When will it be over?
Basically tomorrow.
How about tomorrow night?
Huh?
Do you bowl?
As much as anyone should.
Well, I bowl with the Madam Kim's nail salon team, and we need a sub.
All right, I'm game. Yeah, you know, I'll be up for a night out after shooting all day.
Really?
Yeah, you know, count me in.
Hi, Sid.
Hey, Dad, what's up?
You got Get a call from a Mr. Beacons at the district attorney's office. Said it was important.
Look, if he calls again, tell him I moved.
Oh.
I knew Nick from Brown. He paid me a visit today.
Personal?
Not exactly. Gave me a friendly warning about Paul.
Sid, look, your business is your business, but I'm wondering if this relationship with Paul is a good thing for you.
Why?
I like the Ritigliatos. Carl is a sweet man who loves his animals, and Paul seems like a nice guy, but they have a reputation in this town, and I'm afraid it's not going to do you any good. You know what I mean?
I think so. So you're saying that if I stop seeing Paul, you'll stop treating Carl's animals?
Come on, Sid.
Dad, there's nothing to worry about. Okay?
Hot date?
Shh. Oh. Just going out with Paul for a quick bite. No biggie.
Then why are you shushing me?
Oh, Dad doesn't really want me to go out with Paul because...
He's afraid you'll get whacked in a mob hit.
Joanie.
Hey, I'm a big fan of bad boys. Besides, it's nice to see you lying and sneaking out of the house for a change.
I'm not gonna lie to Dad. If he asks me, I'll tell him. I'm an adult. I make my own decisions.
So you, going out the back way?
If Dad does ask.
Oh, I'm no snitch.
Thanks.
Il conto alla tavola 3, eh? Ah, buonasera, buonasera. Tutto a posto, Paolo?
Come sempre.
Bene, bene.
E questo è il nostro anno, Matteo?
L'anno prossimo.
Tu sempre dici lo stesso.
This man, he was the one who sponsored me to come to America. Now he can't wait for me to go back home. I have Michelangelo here. Why do I need Florence? And you, you have such a beautiful woman. Why do you need Florence, eh? Piacere. Buonasera. Ah, buonasera.
What was that all about?
Michelangelo's the Holy Family. It hangs in the Uffizi. I met Matteo when I was studying in Florence. I keep trying to get him to go back to visit, but he hates to fly.
What were you studying?
Sculpture. I wanted to be the next Michelangelo.
Really? Do you still sculpt?
No. I'm a businessman now. But I'll tell you a little secret. Every year, I go back and I lay my hands on the original statues and I feel the indentations and the sweep of his thumb. And for a moment, I am Michelangelo.
I am impressed.
Don't be. As a plastic surgeon, you're more of a sculptor than I'll ever be.
Right. Well, if the David ever wants a nose job, I'm your girl. You know, I wasn't going to tell you about this, but an acquaintance of mine from school is now working at the DA's office. He came in to see me today. He wanted to warn me that you were under investigation.
That doesn't surprise me, but they're wasting their time.
I'm sorry that I have to ask you this again, but is there something I should know?
Actually, there is. I've never broken the law in my life. And I would never put you in a compromising situation. There's nothing I haven't told you, Sid. Nothing.
Mr. Ritigliato, please.
What is it?
It's a subpoena to appear before the grand jury.
What?
Come on.
Vai fuori! Fuori! Non è un mio posto! Non ti voglio vedere più!
All rise! Here comes the judge.
This court will come to order.
Mom, what's going on?
You got yourself in deep this time, kid. And call me, Your Honor. Bring forth a witness.
Helen?
Okay, Canary, sing.
She let the mob put a roof on the clinic. Now it's a speakeasy. You know, craps, dice, booze. There's no room to treat patients anymore. And it's all because of her.
Come on, Helen, you love the cappuccino machine.
Cappuccino? That sounds good. Paul?
Two sugars, right, doll? I mean, Your Honor.
Sweet talker.
Mom! Your Honor.
What am I being charged with?
Lots of stuff. Bad stuff.
Could you be a little more specific? How am I supposed to defend myself?
You should have thought of that before you started running with the bad crowd. Next witness.
I told her to slow down, see, but she wouldn't listen. I guess she's just no good.
Dad?
Can I get cinnamon with this?
Next!
Sit a straight arrow, I tell you. She would never, ever... On second thought, she did it.
Robbie!
I'm sorry, sis. They told me to squeal arrows. Going back up the river. I can't go back up there again. I just can't. How are you with lattes?
Final witness!
Sure, I caught her sneaking out. She asked me to cover for her, but I ain't taking the fall. It was her. It was her all along.
Are you a little stooly?
Wait a minute.
Wait a minute. Polly, say something, Paul.
I've never broken the law in my life.
What?
I believe you.
Mom!
She's guilty. Get her out of here.
Hey! You're all a bunch of stoolies, that's what you are!
We're going to the big house, sister!
Hey! Hey!
Oh, come on in.
Nothing to worry about, isn't that what you said?
What is it? The whole thing was staged to embarrass Paul's family.
Yeah, well, I can't speak for his family, but it certainly embarrassed mine.
Well, I never thought about it like that.
Exactly. You didn't think about it. Sid, your patients read this paper, not to mention the board of the university hospital.
Well, there's not much I can do about that now.
I think there is. I think you can get out of it before something worse happens.
Look, I am an adult. I can handle this.
How clear do you want me to be? I think you should stop seeing him.
Or what? You're gonna ground me? I'm sorry, Dad, but this is just... Wait a minute! Dad!
Where's my Hannah? She had a stuffy nose. Kept her up all night, so I sat up with her.
Didn't even hear her.
Oh, good. I wanted you to get some sleep. You're shooting your commercial, right?
Right. Wow, that was incredibly nice of you, Lily.
I already get dressed for school.
Is everything okay, Lily?
Fine. Good luck today.
Hey, you got a minute? Not in the mood for another lecture.
Okay, I'll try to restrain myself. Have you noticed anything weird about Lily lately?
Weird? No, I mean, she's helping out a lot.
Well, yeah, I'll say I haven't had to change a diaper in, like, days. She's doing all the laundry, she's cooking, she's practically darning socks.
Well, she quit smoking, too, but what are you complaining about?
Well, no, I'm not. I just want to know what's up. You know, she's running herself ragged.
Well, let's go talk to her.
Okay.
Lily!
Oh, I guess she already left for school.
Yeah, you know, I'm gonna write her a note. What's she doing with this?
Hey, you know, you really shouldn't be reading other people's mail.
Well, I'm in luck. This one's addressed to me.
Child Welfare Services. Gal, this was dated a week ago.
Yeah. Dear Dr. Hansen, the temporary agreement we made for the care of Lily Gallagher will soon expire. I need to make arrangements for her transferal to a foster home. Please call my office.
So she's been campaigning to stay.
That's what it looks like.
So what are you gonna do?
I don't know.
Smell those treats. Fresh from the oven. They're good. Oh. So good. I'm Joanie Hansen, from Joanie's Barker.
Cut!
Cut. I'm not feeling it, okay? You really gotta love those treats.
But the line doesn't sound right. They're good, oh, so good.
Okay, it's, they're good, oh, so good.
But I would never say that.
Sure you would.
I'm Joanie, of Joanie's Barkery. I think I know what I would say and what I wouldn't.
Fine. Do me a favor. Just once, let me hear it as scripted, all right?
Fine.
Excuse me.
Still no sign of that dog man?
No, he was supposed to pick up his costume and been here an hour ago. And by the way, his name is Storm McCloud.
Oh, the weather guy from Channel 3.
Well, it wasn't until he announced that he was sleeping with the station owner's wife on the 6 o'clock news. Thought his mic was turned off.
Ouch.
Yeah, well, that's all right. Guys like that always land on their feet.
I have combed the city looking for this place. The word on the street is that Joanie's bark. Oh my God, what have I become?
Oh, geez, he's hammered.
Mr. McLeod? Storm? Hey, Storm!
Sir, I am a meteorologist, not one of your mangy mutts.
Mr. Hudson, you need to keep moving, and if the weather's not nice, you should do a couple of laps inside the mall.
Okay.
Sid, the lab just called about the urine results on the McDonald kid.
Oh, good. I've been waiting for those.
And you're gonna have to keep waiting. The sample came back contaminated.
Contaminated?
Joanie's bark, scene 2, take 3. And action!
Hi, I'm Joanie Hansen. Welcome to Joanie's Barkery.
Cut!
Hi, I'm Joanie Hansen. Welcome to Joanie's... Hi, I'm Joanie Hansen. Welcome to Joanie's Barkery.
Cut! Joanie, would you step up to the tape and deliver the line?
Don't bark at me.
That's funny. That's very funny. Ringo, get back in your place.
Scene 4, take 1.
And while you're here, you can enjoy a delicious assortment of my special dog bites.
Those sound good. Oh,
Ringo, beat it! What am I, in the middle of some kind of doggy love triangle? This is not what it looks like! Come on.
I just can't work like this.
So you're dragging Paul in front of a grand jury to put pressure on his father?
Yeah.
How can you do that to an innocent man?
He's not exactly innocent.
Oh, look, whatever his father may have done, Paul has never broken the law.
Let's just say it was broken for him.
What do you mean?
Let's just stop there, okay? I don't want to compromise the case against him.
Against Paul? Nick, Paul is a good man. He's generous to the community. He's even donating a new roof to the clinic.
When? Has the work started yet?
What difference should that make?
Sid, I'm gonna give you one final warning, okay? Do not accept that roof.
Why shouldn't I? You have no evidence that Paul's done anything wrong.
Those roofing materials were manufactured by a company that used to launder money for the Redigliato family.
Oh, I don't believe that. Paul's been meticulous at keeping his business clean.
He may not have known. It doesn't matter. Those materials will link you and your clinic directly to mob activity. If you accept that roof, the DA will shut down your clinic, and he'll subpoena you to testify against Paul.
Let me look at it.
It's okay, Heather. I have another one. For now, anyway.
Just sit. Just sit. Okay.
Heather, you are smoking. How long have you been bowling?
Ever since I was too little to pick up the ball.
Well, I hope I'm not embarrassing with my piddly little 125.
I could never be embarrassed of you.
Hey, what's her name?
Kira. Why?
Has she seen anyone?
I don't know.
Think you could find out for me? What's wrong? Well, if it's too weird for you, I can ask her myself. I'm not shy about these things, you know.
No, I'll get her number for you.
Thanks, Heather. You're the best.
I wanted to get here before the workmen arrived to install the new roof.
I'm afraid they won't know where it goes.
We have to refuse it. There may be a problem, and it's just not worth risking the clinic. Oh, blood work's back on Jackie McDonald. Everything looks normal. Now all I have to do is figure out why a 14-year-old boy has mood swings, sleep disturbances, and hot flashes.
That's easy, menopause. Did the lab ever figure out what the contaminant was in his urine sample?
Yeah. Just right here. Whew. That clears things up.
Don't tell me pregnancy.
No. Tidy bowl. You know, something tells me I'm not getting the whole story here. Hi, I'm Dr. Sydney Hansen from St. Clair's Clinic. You must be Jackie's aunt.
Jackie doesn't have an aunt. I'm his mother.
Oh, great. Well, you're back.
Back? I'm sorry, I have no idea what you're talking about.
I examined Jackie a couple days ago at the clinic. He came in on his own, said that you were out of town.
You'd better come in.
Thank you.
Jackie doesn't like to worry me. Since his dad died, everybody tells him he's the man of the house.
Sometimes we don't realize how seriously kids take statements like that.
Is something wrong with Jackie?
Well, he came in complaining of stomach pains, mood swings, and hot flashes.
Sounds more like me.
How long have you had these symptoms?
Oh, a couple of months.
Have you seen a doctor about them?
Why? You think it sounds serious?
Could be. Mind if I take a look at your neck? Just turn around here for a sec. Hey, Jackie. Got your test results back.
Oh, yeah? What'd you find out?
You've got the cleanest urine in Providence.
What do you mean?
Tidy bowl?
You wanted a urine sample, so I broke the handle so the toilet wouldn't flush.
And got a sample from your mom. It's okay. You were worried about her, huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, you did good. Your mom, she has a thing called hyperthyroidism.
Is she gonna be okay?
Yeah, if she gets treatment right away, she'll be fine.
She's working all the time. She won't come down here.
I think she might.
Mom.
Honey. I hear you've been looking out for me.
I just don't want anything to happen to you, Mom.
You listen to me, baby. You're the kid. I'm the mom. It's my job to take care of you. From now on, I promise I'll take better care of myself, okay?
Okay.
Okay. You wanted to talk to me?
Yeah, Lily. I spoke with social services today. The agreement we made for you to stay with me expires on Monday.
I'll make this easy. Tell Mr. Mendoza to pick me up after school.
I could do that, but we were kind of hoping that you might want to stay with us.
What?
I spoke to Dad and Joanie. What'd he say? I take it that's a yes.
Good afternoon, Dr. Hansen.
Hi, Sal.
Mr. Ritigliato needs to speak to you right away, so if you'll just step inside, we'll get going.
Why would Mr. Ritigliato want me?
Well, you know, he doesn't really discuss those things with me, but if you're asking, you're a beautiful woman, you're smart, good
Sal?
Dresser.
Sal, are you talking about Paul?
Oh, yeah. Something very urgent he needed to discuss with you.
Oh, okay.
You know, it was my day to run errands, and I told him that I'd be happy to find you. Plus, my dry cleaning won't be ready for, like, a whole nother hour.
Sal?
So I figured... Oh, right.
These walls could talk. I used to sneak up here with, like, all the... I probably shouldn't give you any ideas now that I'm sort of like your big sister.
I always wanted a big sister.
Really? I've always wanted a little sister. Actually, I think I just didn't want to be the little sister.
Why? Sid is so great.
Exactly. She was, like, valedictorian, and I flunked basic math. And she was prom queen, and I was being suspended for drinking beer behind the horticulture lab.
My grandma used to tell me how her big sister would braid her hair, and they would have pillow fights. And that when she got older, her sister would always make sure that she didn't get into too much trouble. Maybe if we'd known each other sooner, maybe it'd have been easier for the both of us.
Well, we'll pick it up from here. I'm not really a big fan of braids, but...
Are you in trouble?
Not anymore. My father made a deal to clean up his act if the DA agreed to leave me and you alone.
What's the catch?
Just one. I have to leave Providence.
But you didn't do anything.
Now, the DA wants me gone, so I'm not tempted to rebuild my father's business. My father wants me to leave, so I don't get hauled in for questioning every time the DA gets angry. It's a family thing, Sid. Dad wants me to go. I gotta go. As long as I'm in Providence, I can't escape the family business, and neither can the people I care about.
I don't want you to go.
I've caused you enough trouble.
So this is it?
For now. I want to ask a favor of you before I go.
Want me to give you a new face?
No. One last dance.
Come on, sit down already.
Here she is, woman of the hour.
Okay, this production could not have been made without the help of many of the people in this room. So, thank you, and enjoy.
Yay!
Lights.
Smell those treats fresh from the oven. They're good. Really, really good. Hi, I'm Joanie Hansen. Welcome to Joanie's Barkery.
Hey, Joanie! This place and word on the street is Joanie's Barkery is the hot new hangout.
That's right. And while you're here, you can enjoy a delicious assortment of my special pet bites.
Oh, so good. Oh, so good. Patino and Chuck. Hey, guys, it's me!
Cook up with old friends or make new ones at Joanie's Barkery. Bring your owner. In fact, all civilized species are welcome. Joanie's Barkery, located at 5776 Bentley Avenue, open every day from 10 to 5.
Whoa!
Great job, Joanie.
You're a star.
So you saved it.
We got some good stuff.
Yeah, you just had to dress up like a dork and get mauled.
Yeah, well, at least I was supposed to look like a dork, Miss 50s wannabe.
Hey, I liked my outfit.
You okay?
I will be.
What you got?
Something Mom gave me a long time ago. I was in junior high and I came crying to Mom about a boy who broke my heart. I don't think she knew what to do about it any more than I did. Out of sheer desperation, she was searching through the junk drawer and she pulled this out. I think it was an old Christmas tree ornament or something. She told me that Mr. Wright was out there somewhere waiting for me, looking. That whenever my heart broke, I should ring this bell and he'd hear it and be that much closer to finding me.
Your mom said that?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, she was a quick thinker. I just tried to distract you with a double scoop from McDear's. Did you ring it yet?
Oh, no, it's just a stupid thing I used to do as a kid. You know, I see these couples and, I wonder what I'm doing wrong. And what do they know that I don't know?
Oh, nothing, sweetie, nothing. I think the trick is just to keep your heart open so that you're ready when it's your turn. I could sure use some ice cream. How about you?
That sounds great.
I'll go see if anybody else wants some.
In a meeting.